Breaking Sony, Marvel, and MCU news, Sony Pictures is developing a female-led superhero film for their Spider-Man universe, and it's not who you think. Who the f*** is Jackpot? What's up, everybody? It's Josh. Welcome back to the channel. Smash that like button like Jackpot, who I guess has super strength? And let's get right into this video. Apparently, Sony thought even Spider-Woman, who's already a pretty obscure character, was too famous. And so they've went with someone even less well-known to be their first female-led superhero for their Spider-Man universe. This is coming from Deadline. I'm going to read right from the article a little bit, and then we're going to talk about what it means, okay? Mark Guggenheim scripting Spider-Man universe heroine Jackpot movie for Sony Pictures. Exclusive. Sony Pictures is determined to expand its Marvel Spider-Man universe headlined by a female superhero. The studio has hired Mark Guggenheim, writing the script for Jackpot, a feature about a crime-fighting mom in the comics. Guggenheim has written episodes of that comic series with Brian Reed. Jackpot is a superheroine with exceptional strength, and her history in the comics is a complicated one. First incarnation was Sarah Ert, a scientist who, while pregnant, is doing gene therapy research and is exposed to Lot 777, a virus that rewrote the DNA in her cells. Her baby is born healthy, but she realizes in addition to being a new mom, she has a superhuman strength after she is forced to save her family. Eventually, she tired of the crime fighting burden and hands the suit to Elena Jobson, an ambitious pal who takes over the character but must ingest a mutant growth hormone to live up to Jackpot's superhuman abilities. Long story short, she is killed when teaming with Spider-Man to track down the villain Menace and is killed in action. A guilt-ridden Ert returns to the job, keeping her identity secret as she raises a family while fighting crime. Now, they go on in the article to talk about Guggenheim, and he's got comic book credits for Aquaman, Amazing Spider-Man, and Superman, and Batman, and video game credits including Call of Duty 3, and on the film and television department, he worked in Law & Order, Jack and Bobby, CSI Miami, and was doing some stuff with Studio 8 to adapt Prophet, an Image comic character created by Rob Liefeld. Now, what I know about Guggenheim is that he helped out with the CW universe. He helped out with Arrow. He helped out with The Flash and Legends of Tomorrow. Okay, so he's no stranger to nerd culture out there, but Jackpot kind of is. So a couple of different things here. I mean, first of all, like, it is kind of memeably hilarious that we had all these rumors of a Spider-Woman movie or a Silk movie or even Silver and Black, right? Literally. And they're all pretty obscure characters. Like, the comic book fans know who they are, but they're all pretty obscure. I'm sorry, but Jackpot is, like, even more obscure. So it's, like, it's just really weird that they're going that way. And I can't help but think maybe there's something in this about the Spider-Woman character. Remember, there was a lot of talk about how Spider-Woman was going to be streamlined, but Spider-Woman was this contested character. She's partially owned by Marvel. She's partially owned by Sony. There were even talks that, like, hey, these guys are going to work together to have that character be in both universes. That's really cool. Looks like none of that is happening. They've chosen to go with this character. Now, I actually like the idea of a badass mom that wants to fight crime, okay? So she gets the superpower. She wants to fight crime. She doesn't want to fight crime at one point. She's like, no, I'm just going to be a mom. She passes the mantle on, and the person she passes it to dies, okay? That's pretty wild. And then she decides to become an actual superhero. I actually kind of like the idea of, like, a mom superhero. Like, in the same way that, like, Peter Parker was dealing with being a high school student and being poor, right? Living in Queens and having all these problems. That's a really interesting take where it's like, that's what his real life is like, and then he has to go be Spider-Man. It would be kind of interesting to see a mom doing mom things, living a mom life, and then going on to be a superhero. I actually think that's kind of interesting. But how are they going to market it? Like, she's super obscure. Like, how are they going to market it? Now, a couple of things that this shows, it definitely shows that this Sony Marvel universe is expanding. They're trying to grow this thing out. They want a bunch of different characters. And this character feels like, to me, someone that can fit really well with the character of Solo and with perhaps what Sony is looking to do with either S.H.I.E.L.D. or a S.H.I.E.L.D.-like organization over there for their universe. I think they want some kind of centralized organization that will help tie things together and tie into bigger plots as they move forward. I think that she fits the bill for that. And I'll tell you what would be really interesting is if Sony went for a take on this type of a female-led character that was very different than what they did with Captain Marvel. Now, look, we've talked about Captain Marvel at great length, right? This is this internet thing, right? Some people are like, oh, it's too preachy. It's too woman power. Well, what if they did something very different with this Jackpot character over there at Sony? Like, they tried to make, like, a relatable character, and instead of it being, like, this younger, sassy female that's, like, looking to get hers and trying to fight against oppression, what if the take on this is literally just, like, she's a mom? Like, that's it. Like, she's a mom, and there's a whole ridiculous element there, and then they play off of that. I think that could be interesting, and you could try to sort of counter program to what they're doing over there at Marvel. I don't know. Seems like that could be a cool strategy. I also think it's really interesting that they're getting Mark Guggenheim, who has literally written that character before in Marvel's actual comics and has worked, you know, in TV and stuff too. But it's so interesting to get him to come in and work on the script. This reminds me of the move that Ezra Miller did when he tried to get Grant Morrison to co-write a script with him for The Flash. I think that is actually really interesting. And I know that there are people that have been very good comic book writers that can write for television and for cinema. Christopher Yost is one of the best examples. Christopher Yost is a brilliant comic book writer, and he's also just brilliant at adapting work for other mediums. He knows television really, really well. He knows movies and things like that. You'll see his name pop up in credits of all kinds of stuff. And this is one of those things that, like, we're just going to have to wait and see what fans think, because I know there's a lot of dogging on Sony, and I've been one of these people that's defended Sony. I'm like, no, this is cool. It's cool that they're doing this. I'm glad they're doing their own thing. But then there's been some announcements that come out, and you're just like, geez, Sony, like, what? Like, what are you thinking? And I can't help but think that this Jackpot thing is like, it's so weird. Like, why would you go with Jackpot? I really don't understand. Silk's more popular. Like, look, I've said it all. I'm going to be very interested to see what fans think. So please, if you're a fan out there, let us know what you think about this. Like, what do you think about Sony developing a Jackpot movie? Is this the droid you're looking for, or not quite, and why? Let us know in the comments section below. And now let's shout out Frank Escobar. Yes, indeed, Tarble is Vegeta's younger brother. So shout out to you, Frank. And now let's ask another nerd card question before we get out of here. I want to know if you can finish this phrase. Face it, Tiger, you just hit the blank. This famous phrase was uttered by Mary Jane in the comic books. Answer the question, what is the missing word of that phrase? Answer that in the comment section below. If you absolutely need more nerdy content in your life, click or tap over there to watch some more of our videos, or come on by our live streaming channel where we stream every day, Monday through Friday, starting at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Like this video if you liked it. If you want to take your support to the next level and join the list of amazing people you see listed below, check out our Patreon for some behind-the-scenes content. As I always say, I hope you're having an awesome and a nerdy day, and I'll see you in the next video.